Playing Minecraft. More Minecraft today. The addiction never ends. So, plenty of Minecraft. Just tweeting out now. And then, yeah. We'll get started. Been trying to, like, I've done a couple of stuff off stream of Minecraft because, you know, the Minecraft addiction, and I've been one of those things is trying to get wither skeleton skulls, but it's so damn hard. They don't drop it. I don't know how one got so many. I'm very jealous. But I've been trying to get that so that I can build a beacon. I want to hollow out like large areas and stuff, and I need the haste for that, I think. So that's part of the stuff I want to do today, is I have one of the wither skulls, so just trying to get the last two, so I can, or like at least like one more, like at least like ready for once I have the beacon. There's so much to dig out. Even just like at my house still. I've also tried to be helpful on the server, so I built a bee farm for like honey box and stuff. Fun. I think that's the only really things I have done, to be honest. Just the bee farm and trying to get wither skulls to minimal success. Just spawn. But once I get that, because one of the big things I need him for is to make a slime farm, because I want to make a lot of stuff with like redstone pistons and all that, and which is part of why I made the bee farm, so that we have lots of honey blocks, because that's really useful for like large scale piston stuff. So I need slime blocks for that, and so I think my base hack, like, just coincidentally happens to be on a slime trunk, which is pretty convenient, so hopefully that part's easy, but I do need to hollow out the rest of the stuff, and I do need to control it. Unfortunately, they don't like to drop it. Who would have thought beheading people is so difficult? They make it seem so easy in real life. It's crazy. I mean, what? But yeah, besides that, I think I have most of the materials for building like a slime farm. Maybe I need some of the magma and stuff, because a lot of the designs use that. But other than that, it's just like hollowing out a big area, which shouldn't be that bad. Trying to keep most of my like buildings and stuff underground and out of sight, because I know I don't build the prettiest stuff. I'm mainly fairly utilitarian, or like not utilitarian, swords, like more brutalist and built for like function. So hopefully, I'll be able to build something. Because it's all working up, all the slime blocks and everything, it's all working up to one big end goal, which is building Shipkin Shippa at the end. That's why I've been making a bunch of like oxidized copper for the boat, and then I want to build a dry dock, which is what I want the honey and slime for, is to make it so that I can open and close like a big, like dry dock gates or something, make it look nice. It's all working towards that one goal. Only you drop slime blocks as well. That'll make things so much easier. So yeah, it's pretty unfortunate because there's not really a slime, like a swamp or anything nearby the like paper town or anything like that. So if I'm right about my base having a slime trunk, which I'm still not 100% sure on, that's good. If not, I'm gonna probably have to be at the nearest swamp, which is like very far away. But getting the deep dark stuff is helpful. Like if he's there and I have some of the resources, so that's gonna be useful in the next with the 1.2 update. They add a bunch of like they add some usefulness for the scope sensors. So I'm hoping that whenever that comes out, I don't know Minecraft. I mean, it takes like forever for like updates that don't have a lot. So who knows when this one's gonna come out? But if that does, if when it does, I'll be able to do a lot with like redstone and stuff with that. Yeah, they just don't seem to spawn anywhere. It's very annoying. I don't know if it's like the torches or something, or just like natural spawning. But I don't think the torches matter that much in like the end, as far as I remember. Oh, here you are. I don't really have a ranged weapon for those. Probably should get one. I just want to get like one more skull so I can say I did something in the Nether and then go back and start working on like the other stuff. Maybe gather some more materials. Another skull's right down here. I can hear you. is it just one of you? Damn. That's not helpful at all. At least it gives plenty of coal. Playing on the flavor server has really brought back my Minecraft addiction. Mainly of just digging like large holes and giving myself stupid projects like that. That very mind numbing and I hate. But it is nice having like the challenge of digging stuff. Just need two more skulls, then I can give it another shot with an even larger thing. The dry dock. Though that's not doesn't need to be as deep. If it's as deep, like it's gonna be useless. So it just needs to be a lot wider, which I don't know if that's better. Yeah. I'm sorry I wasn't able to stream yesterday. There was just some family stuff that came up that made it a bit difficult. Because I'm still like family, and I have Emily also like in like pretty close next room down the hallway. I have to be a bit careful. Stuff is on. You can't always read what you want. No. But still, I'm gonna like try to. Because I do have a lot of fun, just even if it's just talking to myself, just rambling, and I need to finish Dead Space. It gives me a good excuse to not just play games all day because I want to keep some games for stream and stuff. It's nice that I'm at least not dying as easily to them like I was before. I upgraded my armor and everything. Though I still did die like 20 minutes before. before stream. So it's not always. Rika's been working on like redstone doors and stuff, so I'm assuming it's like piston doors. I even made a sword specifically for this, like Smite 5 and everything. It's been helpful, but we only have one. The other problem with building the dry dock is I need to find somewhere like thing that has ocean. We're not super close to an ocean. In Flavortown. Though there is a couple that I've spotted out. I think are good. I want it to be like, you know, easy enough to get to, but out of the way enough that it's not interfering with anyone else's. At least that's closer than the swamps. The oceans are closer than the swamps are. That's something. The swamps are so far. They're like even farther than like Julian's places. Maybe it is the torches that aren't helping. Go like break some of the torches, I guess. In the... Like not here, close to where he has the Rika made the arm. Thank you. approaches up this way. I don't think most people are going out this way. Unless you're looking for the skulls. I was considering just making like the like trying to like bridge between like stuff, like flatten it out a lot, and see if that helps. I'm not sure if that like connect these with like netherrack in between it and all that, because I still have a bunch of netherrack from, like mining out stuff. I'm not sure like how helpful that would actually be in terms of like increasing the spawns and stuff. Okay, yeah, so it seems like it definitely, the torches does affect it. That's good. Now that. Maybe I should have brought more food, though. Still, like, if I just wander around and on the server, there's still so many places that I just, like, see and, like, I didn't know that existed. Because, for the most part, I've stayed relatively in, like, the spawn. And I haven't wandered off too far. Just, like, building my stuff. But there's still so much to explore. Oh, okay, one more skull. Right. So we have two now. Which is something. And once I get a third, I can do. There's the trick that Julian did with, like, trapping it in the end. Still not 100% sure I remember how he did it. It looks like Rika's piston door broke. So, just the opening, I guess. And then there's skeletons. I don't want to get out. Sword. Oh. enchant a bow. I don't have a bow, so let's see, is this any good? What can I draw? Power two. I can keep it, I guess. No reason why not. For you blazes, if you just replaced all the blazes, or at least some of them with the spell tags, I probably have it by now. Are you gonna be the one? Sound like a Geiger counter sometimes. It's just me hearing things. But I swear I hear like the Geiger counter like rattling. Always get in the way. That could have gone better. Oh, we got the third though. Awesome. I'm head back. Guess it couldn't have gone better then. I can show you the bee, all the bee farm on the way. It isn't the best designed, but it's something. Some spare parts. Oh, I have some. Yeah, but yeah, so here's the bee farm. I want to make this into the plan. So the plan here is to make it with the piglin trading. Like if you get, you know, if you give them gold, they can drop stuff. So to trap a bunch of them in here and like pseudo automate the process a bit would be great. One thing with the bee farm is they do spawn in here sometimes. And I haven't figured out a way to fully do that. I am working on it. But I know some of the nether mobs aren't like affected by the light levels, so they can spawn in any light level. Which I'm assuming is because of, like, if they have lava and stuff nearby, they want them to still be able to spawn. does make it very annoying. Trying to have this one. Because it kind of bleeds into that, like, nether wart forest biome, which is why they end up spawning. How many honey blocks do we get? 10's pretty good. Has given me a good use for a lot of the stuff that I get. We get from the iron farm with the poppies, because I can just bring them over here, use them to breed the bees, and to help them grow. So at least it gives me a good. Back home, still working on more copper. I am up to like. How many stacks now? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 stacks of fully oxidized. And then I still have more stacks of non-oxidized, but we're making progress on those, which is great. That's all going towards building the ship once she's ready. So I need. And I need to go to the end. I don't quite remember what Julian did for his thing in the end. But I know I need sand and the skulls and to hollow out a big area. I think I need obsidian too for. That should give us plenty of obsidian. And I can stock up on food over here. So noisy. That's the one thing about having so many of them. But yeah, I think 9's supposed to be enough. So if I remember correctly, all we really need to do is go. Do I need a minecart? Well, I guess. Just go to the end. Dig a big area out that I can, you can trap it underneath, I think. One second. sorry. Yeah, just family stuff that they want to ask me about. So I think apparently this travels all the way to where the stronghold is. I haven't been down here. Looks like Rick is still struggling with the festival. Yes, I'm not sure entirely what that is, to be honest. Apparently it's wrong. Hopefully he's just doing that to get rid of the phantoms, because I don't know if it's nearby. I haven't actually been to the end before on this server, so I don't know, like, where the stronghold is, like, when we'll get there, or what the end looks like. At least it doesn't seem like we're that deep underground or anything. It looks like we're heading down towards it now. I want to see if there's enough iron ore just so I can make us a miner if we way back. Actually, the apples are useful. The bread is not. Because the apples, you can make golden apples and stuff. Doesn't count. There's gotta be some in here somewhere. I'm not bringing a crafting table either. Well, then there's not really a good point. I'm getting iron. So I can craft anything. Okay. I'm gonna try to see how Julian. I don't want to have to go and get the skulls all over again. So. I think I got it. think it's gotta be like size around this. Ideally. I guess we went deeper than this thing. Seems like Ruka's still struggling. I want to do it like after like Juanda. What is example? Looks like you just do. This is gonna either go great or it's just gonna go poorly. Okay, looks like it's. I didn't know you could hear it in the overworld. Now we just wait, I guess. could do a bedrock. You can change the river. I'm trying to build a nether portal here. Is that even possible? Awesome, we got the little star. Now we disassemble this and fill it all in. Leave no trace. I've already seen the like end credit stuff on my own, and I'm pretty long, so didn't want to bore y'all with that. Sort of set open combat. I think you'd figure it out pretty easily. Can I just fly up here? Oh. Technically, yes, I guess. I think it's just, if I go this way, yeah. Oh, yeah. We just fly back. What else do we need? Glass, right? Yeah, we need like glass for the gun, and then iron. But iron's easy to get. Got a farm here. Let's go pop in on Rika and see how the looks pretty nice opening, like close it like that. Ah. Does look very nice close. To help, I guess. Not really sure what I did there. Get some wire. A bit to the villagers here so I can trade for a bit of glass and then build a beacon somewhere. So I'm not sure specifically where I should build a beacon. There's the trade. We're the ones that trade. Yeah, I didn't realize that he had to do it slowly, Temp. I was just, you know, I figured he said open it, and so I did. Like, he said click it twice, and so I did. But how was I supposed to know? I don't think it bodes well for my redstone building future, though, that I didn't realize that. I think there's gonna be a lot of trial and error there. We have the iron now, we have the glass to make the beacon. and it's so it oxidizes so weirdly. Like this, I feel like this is supposed to not be as, like it's it doesn't oxidize like all at the same rate, because these were placed down at the same time that all of these were, but these haven't oxidized at all. These are fully oxidized, and it drives me insane. I don't want to get rid of the llamas, to be honest. Like the vomiting llama noises. So I don't want to put it in my house because I don't want to change anything. I think I need more iron still. Works so fast. Yeah, it's this isn't perfectly. It's not perfectly oxidizing. It's very annoying. But yeah, I still have like, you know, 2.5 stacks, plus there's more, I think, somewhere else. I don't know where. Oh, yep, another. If I pick them up, they keep the oxidization level, so I could just. Yeah, which is. That's the important thing, because if they didn't, then. God, that would. I would have to wait, like, an actual. Because if you put them any closer than this, they start to take, like, literal decades to oxidize. It's very annoying. So this is like the supposed to be the best distance, and it does work a lot faster, but it's just very inconsistent in how fast they oxidize and everything, which just gives me a headache trying to sort that out. All right, so now we have like 2 stacks. Hopefully that's enough. I need to figure out. I don't know how far down it reaches. I know it has to see the surface. So like, I think if I go like 2 levels here, hopefully. Maybe 3. Which is still, a lot of this is still unfinished. Because I wanna, I basically need to hollow out like another, bit farther here, because I think that this is the slime trunk here. It's like around this area. So, dig a bit this way. Four. Okay. 4's not that bad, right? Ideally, I can just dig straight up from where the beacon is here, and hopefully not hit lava or anything. And then... Yeah, I like digging out the big, like, I really like having the big open. This, normally I don't go this deep, but I figured I wanted to put it all, make it very compact, because, like I said, I'm in the big, you know, kind of close to the center of town and stuff, and I didn't want it to be, like, expanding underground, too far horizontally and like interfere with other people's stuff. So I just went straight down, and now I'm slowly expanding a bit to like the side, for like just to have a bit more space. But I want it to be mainly vertical. And most of that was done with like moss, because it's a lot easier to do with that way than to just completely do it by hand. If you use moss, you can just use the hoe really fast. And so the goal with the beacon here, a part of it, which I want to test, is if I can just break moss like as fast as I can with the hoe, then I can with like my fist and haste too, then that will make things a lot easier, because then I don't have to worry about like replacing hoes, and it will be basically completely self-sufficient because it makes enough bone meal that I can just replace the moss by just breaking it like normally. So I won't need to, and if I don't need to get any hoes or anything, then it's completely like self-sufficient and doesn't need any other materials. And then I can use this for future. I can move the beacon somewhere else whenever I need to do this somewhere. And even if it doesn't work the way I'm hoping it does with, oh, I didn't make this quite. Even if it doesn't work quite the same way, it's going to make things a lot faster to dig with the pickaxe anyways. Because the big problem I found when digging out stuff with moss is basically you will just run out of like stone and stuff really easily for making like, because I was using stone hoes because they're the cheapest, but I was running out of the material because it requires a lot to keep making because they break really easily. And same even with the iron ones. Moss is basically, it's not super useful for anything else, but if you use bone meal on it, it will like spread onto nearby stone, and because it's a bit easier to break than stone, I use it for like when I'm digging out something big like this, because I can get a bunch of bone meal and I can convert the moss once it's broken into bone meal with a composter, and then it allows me to just hollow out big areas like somewhat more efficient, certainly in like the earlier stages when you don't have diamond tools and stuff. Now it's probably about equal, but it is still nice for just having to haul out a big area. And what's also nice is it does not affect like ores and stuff, so you can still get ores from the area even if you're using the method, but you don't get the stone as easily, unfortunately. I'm gonna need more iron. Mess this up. I made this too wide. Oops. Better too wide, I guess. Then. Not wide enough. But yeah, so that's why I used useful like material, I find. And that's why I need to try to make it so that I don't need to like even get I basically can just build it with just like a beacon and that and my fist. Yes, we need more. Damn it. Maybe I'm going to demonstrate it. have some. So pretty much this, if you bone meal it, it will turn it all into moss, and because moss is like a lot different right here. And that's just with my fist normally, so I'm hoping with haste it's basically gonna be like break on touch, and then if it's break on touch, boom, that just means I can just like have bone meal in my hand and just like mine through entire like junk fairly easily. What do I just need more iron for it? God, for Rika's iron farm, also. Right, at least it's starting to oxidize now, that's something. But yeah, so that's why, that's how I dug out. I didn't dig out this with it, but like everything below this point, actually including this area here, that's why there's still like remnants and stuff. So like this part here was done by hand just because I needed stone desperately at this point. Which I don't remember. No, not this. It's the first one that it's this one. It's the first one that isn't finished. Hopefully this is the right range. Most annoying farm of all time, the iron farm. I don't know, I think it's effective. The chicken one's the most annoying in terms of like noise, I feel like. But it is because I'm like someone's at spawn so often, it is really helpful to have like a bunch, which is why I made so many. Is this big enough? No. But after this, I'm gonna have to like dig this up again once I'm done. That's not fun. Oh, I had way more than I needed. Is it not? No. Oh wait, because it has to. Thank you. out of this way. Oh, good luck at work. Thanks for popping in. Good luck with your model as well. Those chickens were narrow by the worst. Oh, what was that for? I just want to close it on the other I assume he's here about the yard. It is like a bad spot to build it when I am trying to maximize the depth. Ideally, it'd just be at the surface. Just like I wanted. so it should be useful now as I am still probably gonna dig this part out by hand. Mostly. Just because I do really need the resources. But it's very helpful. I have boundaries, I'm trying to keep it in. Partly so I don't just make a mess of everything. But yeah, I need to knock all of this down. There's the goal. Far it goes down, it goes. If it goes down all the way, that would be amazing. Well, it goes fairly far down still. And I probably could move it down later. Actually, let's see. Should be fine digging straight down here. Famous last words, I know, but now I can have a decent idea of how far I need to build it. Like, I can just go here. Just dig straight to the next. I'll do the same in the other ones as well. So that I can have a fairly easy place to get this one. That's the one thing about moss is you get a bunch of like the useless, mostly useless blocks that you don't need. Yeah. most of this isn't actually going to be super helpful for the specific stuff itself, because, like I said, I'm going to be mining this up by hand, so I don't need to test all the moss stuff. But it is good getting some, like, the testing and stuff out of the way before I plan to actually... Because I do want to build, like, implement this, basically, type of mining into the next project, which is a lot larger in scale. It's also just good to know, like, how far down the stuff I need to take for all this stuff. I think we'll probably around 1:30 accomplish most of what I wanted on this stream, because the other stuff is just gonna be fairly boring, just digging and trying to find the slime trunk or down this location so that I can build. Maybe we just end it. Satisfying. Okay, I think we'll stop it here. We accomplished pretty much all I need to do or wanted to do. Like the main stuff that's interesting to watch. And yeah, I'm working, gonna work on schedule and stuff. Next week, hopefully about Monday. So trying to find like the ideal times and stuff to work with like my family and me and just schedule like that. But yeah. So Osirin, and thank you for all for coming in and feeding my Minecraft addiction.